Previously, we balanced simple chemical reactions by playing with the coefficients in front of each reactant and product. We will now see how to balance very complex oxidation-reduction reactions occurring in either acidic or basic solutions. We do so by breaking the reaction into two half reactions, an oxidation and a reduction. Please note that in any question, we will specify whether the solution is acidic or basic. Consider the following unbalanced reaction in an acidic solution. As we can see, ions such as MnO4- and Mn2+ that will be free in solution are expressed as ions, and we care not about spectator ions that must necessarily exist in solution. Non-electrolytes such as ethanol, C2H5OH, and carbon dioxide remain intact and are expressed as neutral molecules. The principal reactants and products now defined, we want to identify what is reduced and what is oxidized. To do this, assign the oxidation states of each atom. In this example, we see that Mn is reduced from positive 7 to positive 2, and the C is oxidized from negative 2 to positive 2. We can now start working on our two half reactions, the reduction and the oxidation, in a stepwise fashion. If by any chance you made a mistake on the oxidation numbers, no problem. As long as you have the proper half reactions defined, everything will work out if you observe the following algorithm in each half reaction. Balance the elements other than oxygen and hydrogen. To balance the oxygen atoms, add the appropriate number of water molecules to one side. To balance the hydrogen atoms, add the appropriate number of H+ ions to one side. To balance the charge, add the appropriate number of electrons to one side. Now add the two half reactions together. Before doing so, ensure that the number of electrons accepted in the reduction is the same as the number of electrons lost in the oxidation. This can be achieved by identifying the lowest common denominator and multiplying each half reaction appropriately. In our example, we are now able to add the two half reactions. Prior to doing so, simplify things by canceling off terms that appear on both sides of the half reactions, first and foremost being the electrons, which must be identical on each side. The final step should be to check that this is all well, and that indeed all the elements are balanced, and that the charge is also balanced. If working with a reaction in a basic solution, the process is slightly altered in that an extra step is added. Using the same example, we start with the same two half reactions as before. Again, we do the following. Balance the elements other than oxygen and hydrogen. To balance the oxygen atoms, add the appropriate number of water molecules to one side. To balance the hydrogen atoms, add the appropriate number of H+ ions to one side. Now, in a basic solution, we add the following. For each H+ ion added to one of the two sides, add one OH- ion to each side. At this point, one can combine the H+ ions and OH- ions to form water molecules, and one can further simplify by canceling redundant water molecules on each side. After having done this, one can return to the algorithm previously seen. Balance the charge by adding the appropriate number of electrons to one side. Bring the number of electrons in each half reaction to the same value. Add the two half reactions to obtain a perfectly balanced chemical reaction.